Do you believe in miracles, Michael McCormack?
I believe in miracles.
Are you going to be Prime Minister at the end of the day?
Scott Morrison would have something to say about that, but you never know. Politics is an interesting game.
Is there anything that you think needs to be disclosed? I'm just going on, history.
If people are that paltry, the way they want to fight this is with sort of slurs and innuendo.
No. You sex a thing,
you. I'm fairly upset with all of this.
On the day Parliament was supposed to focus on bushfire victims...
I think that we should be focusing on the bushfires today.
...and our brave firefighters...
...the most self-indulgent act of the National Party.
...spilling their leadership as Barnaby Joyce came after Michael McCormack's job.
You'll never find out.
The result's apparently very close. 11 votes to 10 in favour of the incumbent. These leaked coalition talking points stress Bridget McKenzie lost her ministry and the Deputy National's leadership because transparency matters. But to help get McCormack over the line, guess what? She's already back as Senate leader.
We will continue as a united team.
All right, move on. Nothing to see here.
The shenanigans are over.
Please disperse.
I'd like to think that the entire National Party team, and I know they will now unite.
We've heard that before.
Unity is absolutely critical.
I've shook hands with Barnaby. We're going to move on. We're going to move on and we're going to work hard together.
McCormack's victory today was a win for Scott Morrison too. He would have found it much more difficult to keep Barnaby Joyce under control. The question now is, does Barnaby have another shot in his locker?
I don't expect him to challenge again.
Staying optimistic, Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.